Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the music theory series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. Today I'm going to show you a new guitar plugin and we're going to make some guitar melodies. I really like this plugin because when you play it, you start to think of melodies as you're playing. So for example, I'll just kind of mess around. Because the velocity is set up on this plugin to where when you play softer, it plays like a mute. So when you're naturally playing kind of softer, you'll hear the mute and then it goes into an open string type of formation and your brain starts to think of different rhythms and vibes. Like, so your brain just thinks differently. So this plugin is absolutely free. Shout out to Impact Soundworks. This is called Shredage 3 Stratus Free. That's a tongue twister. And a shout out to, forgive me for it. Let me pull it up. I pulled it up on YouTube and I completely forgot to give credit. Give me 2 seconds to figure out who it is. It is Soul Music Productions. Shout out to Soul Music Productions for putting me onto this. So let's just play around and just noodle until we have a formula. So let's tap it out. So we're at like 97 BPM. Let's record notes and automation. Okay, so one thing on the plugin, if you click on the main screen and click vibrato, it adds this nice R&B type of vibe. Now I played super like, I think my computer's a little laggy here, but so I played a little weird. So I'm going to hit Alt Q to quantize these notes. Also, I'm just going to pull down these velocities here. Just all because they're too hard. Let's hit Alt X, pull those down. Just to get different articulations. Make this note a little longer. When I quantize it, it shortened out the note, so let me make that longer. Hit Alt, left click. So see how we have a vibe without doing anything? And all I'm doing is just playing one chord. I'm just slowly playing into it, so it's playing the triad, and then we're playing the full chord. You don't have to play C. Okay, so you can leave out the seventh. So if you wanted more of like a cleaner tone, you could do that. A little fast, let's slow it down. Okay, so that's one way. Now let's start as if you don't know anything about anything, And let's turn me up a little bit. There we go. My mic was super low. Now I can hear myself. Let's go to contact. Let's right click, go to piano roll, and let us begin. So let's start. So again, when you play softer notes, it creates a mute, and then when you play harder notes, it plays a brighter tone. So let's start low velocity. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a fourth. So we're just playing the black notes. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's tap out the tempo. Dun, 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 dun. All right, let's change the snap to grid. I'm used to producing at like 150 BPM, so I'm not used to these slow BPMs. Also, keep in mind the velocity went up. So again, we're going from soft velocity to this harder velocity. So it opens up the, you get more emotion that way. So I like the way they made the plugin because it makes your brain think of new melodies. So we're just gonna drag this out. So I'm gonna go Okay, and then I'll show you why this works. So in the beginning, We have the fourth, so that's five semitones away, just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we have 6, 7, which makes a fifth. So it goes from the fourth to the fifth, which is always harmonizing with the note. So we're just using perfect intervals to harmonize because these tones always work. And then we're using an octave. So it's fourth, fifth, octave. And these are called perfect unison, perfect fifth, and perfect fourth for a reason, because they always work. Let's use the metronome. It's a little late. Then let's do the same thing, but go. So I'm going to keep the same structure because it's perfect octaves, perfect unison. So we're just going to, all we got to do is make sure that top note is the same as what we're playing. And it will always work. And also you want to mess with the velocities. Now this one, I kind of want a different tone. So notice how the attention for the note that's guiding us through changes. It goes from this high note, now it's the bass notes. That's because this stays the same. So the ear gets used to just stuff that is the same. But you still need like some ear tickling stuff. Like. This may or may not work because we have the bass moving. Let's try it. Sounds pretty dope. So again, the F is right here. So this is an octave. And then right, you know, if we were to add the A sharp, if that's the proper grammar, if the A sharp was there, this would be a perfect fourth, perfect fifth relationship. All we're doing is instead of playing the octave of A sharp or B flat, we're playing the octave of F. So this is all the same notes, and F sharp is over here. Shout out to Impact Soundworks. So I like that. I wanted to repeat it, and I want the end to change. Something like that. Now I'm going to go. So that's just my ear pull me. So this is a small little change. I don't know about the end though. Let's... Sounds pretty dope to me. Now the only thing is the bass loses energy right here, so we want to keep that alive. Trying to find out the ending for the bass. There we go. So this bass, it plays a huge role in the perception of those top notes. So I got to give the bass a little more credit. Now, is this playable as one person? Probably not. This is probably like three different takes of a guitar, all in one. But at least you know how to make the chord. It's not really a chord, it's just, it's interval harmonization. We don't even really need effects. I don't know if they have effects on here. I didn't look around. Let's see. We have a console. Wow, they have effects built in here? That's insanity. There's no way these are... Hold on, let me see something. And they give you effects? That's nuts. This is like the value of this, and it's free. This is ridiculous. They give you a bunch of stuff. If you want to beef it up a little bit, you could add a saturator. I'm trying to take away some of the edge, but I can't figure out what. Maybe that's just the sample. We just need a little delay and reverb. Now, I'll use the built-in delays, but usually I don't like built-in stuff. I just don't like it. But let's add delay. Where would delay be? Delay, where you at? Delay. Put the time at 1/4. Let's turn up the dry a little bit more. Give it some reverb. I'm gonna pull back the saturator a little bit. It's a little bitey. Then let's add the reverb. I'm gonna unlink the wet and dry just so we have more dry signal. Turn up the delay a little bit. They have a lot of stuff in here. I'm actually surprised that there's this much in here. I thought it was just the guitar front, even though this is still a lot. Let's change the key just so we don't get too crazy with this key. Let's hit shift down. One more thing I just thought of. I wonder if we can move. Oh, we can move down. Okay, good. So let's say you can rearrange your effects. Let's add some chorusing in here. Let's move. Chorus. There we go. There's a lot in here. I'm like legitimately entranced because I'm surprised this is free. And shout out to our guys. Was it Soul Music? It is, yeah, Soul Music Productions. Shout out to you. Hit shift up. My ears are so used to. Wait. I forget what key we started in. No, was it here? Yeah, what's this? Let's add some drums just to see if it's official. I told y'all I'd be putting you on. Now I'm going to turn off the built-in effects just so I can have more control over the processing. I do like them though. I'm just going to turn them off for the time being. Let's add one more thing. Let's add gross beat. Gotta add gross beat presets momentary. Let's half time this bad boy. Probably have to lift it up another octave. It's dark because that's that bass in there. Let's try one more thing and then we'll wrap this up. Let's consolidate from track start. All right, so the final check is just to consolidate it to audio and just check a couple things. You can reverse it. Or you could time stretch it. So we could go to stretch mode, stretch this out for double the length. Let's try 8 bars and then pitch it down. Like a breakdown. Okay. You could pull it back and then you could pitch it up. So pull it up 1200 cents. As if you sampled it. Like the Juice WRLD type of sound. That's the sound I like. I would definitely use that for some trap stuff. So that's it. And smash the like button. Subscribe if you're new. I'm loving this new plugin. Peace.